Thank you for plugging into this Family Life News podcast, streaming issues-driven, family-focused news. And welcome back to another edition of Capital Connection. Fridays during the noon report, we give you direct connection to what's happening in Albany and Harrisburg with the experts on the issues at the state capitals. They are Michael Geer at the Pennsylvania Family Institute and Jason McGuire at New Yorkers for Constitutional Freedoms. Jason, before we begin with you, we just want to let our listeners know that you are dealing with a minor medical emergency. So if your speech sounds a little different or strange today, that is what it is. So with that in mind, let's go ahead and jump right in, gentlemen. Where are we, Jay, when it comes to the legal battles in New York over face masks and school and daycare and the vaccine mandates in New York? Seems like every day we're jumping through a lot of hoops on that front. Where are we in New York?
Yeah, it's another day and another lawsuit against these mandates that's coming forward. The biggest one, of course, is the healthcare workers. Those workers had until September 27th to get vaccinated or they would lose their jobs. A judge has now extended that to October 12th. And October 12th, he may issue a preliminary injunction that would extend that through the length of the lawsuit. So there's good news for healthcare workers, at least in the short term. On the mask mandates, a Christian Central Academy in Williamsville, New York, will be back in court on October 1st to find out what's going to happen with their situation.
Yeah, we're following both those stories very closely. When it comes to the vax rules, Michael, you know, abortion rights activists like to say all the time, my body, my choice. Why doesn't the same rule apply when it comes to vaccines?
Well, Bob, you're asking for consistency in public arguments, and as we see, that doesn't happen a whole lot. I mean, the fact of the matter is that my body, my choice is a ridiculous comment right off the bat related to abortion, because it's not just the body of the person who's seeking an abortion, but there's the unborn child that's in the womb that's part of that. And so pro-lifers and anybody with common sense should reject that argument right off the bat. Yeah. Related to the vaccine or just any kind of government-imposed mandate that relates to something like that, there is some sense to that argument to suggest, okay, is there not personal autonomy related to medical treatment? Is it not a tenet of medical care that a patient has the right to refuse treatment? And at least a lot of people are suggesting that should be the case related to vaccine mandates.
Yeah, and you're going to be talking much more about that at that March for Life rally on Monday. Also, this just came in this week in Pennsylvania, efforts to criminalize those who would aid in assisted suicides. It's called Sean's Law. Explain what is going on there.
Yeah, it's a really sad story. It's a young lady, Sean Shadow, who took her own life in May of 2019 after a long battle of depression. So many suicides are really related to the issue of depression and the need for treatment rather than suicide. And this young lady received step-by-step instructions on how to kill herself online. And so her mom, Jackie Bieber from York County, has pushed for a law that's on its way to Governor Wolf's desk that would create penalties for anyone who assists in the suicide of someone under the age of 18 or with intellectual disabilities. So that just passed the House this week and now is awaiting a signature from Governor Wolf, and in all likelihood, I think he'll sign it.
All right, let's head back to Albany. We got our first look at those new-look congressional maps, Jason, that are coming out next year. Dueling versions, one from the Republicans, the other Democrats. Ultimately, do you think that it will be the courts that'll be the ones that decide the political boundary lines in New York?
Well, in November, there's a ballot initiative that would allow the Democratic supermajorities in Albany to take greater control of the process. And Governor Kathy Hochul has already indicated she's willing to gerrymander districts to aid the Democratic Party. So if ballot one is approved in November, it may not even head to the courts. The Democratic supermajorities may just gerrymander their districts to their best interest.
Michael, let's talk about those Wolf waivers. You had mentioned them a lot during the pandemic. These would allow some businesses to stay open. Others were forced to close during the height of COVID-19. Pennsylvania's Auditor General has just come out and said those waivers, a lot of problems with those waivers. What happened there?
Yeah, there's no question about many problems. That's a real painful period in Pennsylvania's history related to COVID, which is basically the governor and his administration behind closed doors were basically deciding winners and losers, which businesses could stay open, which businesses would be forced to close because of the governor's orders. And so Planned Parenthood and abortion clinics were allowed to stay open. But even we had situations where an appliance store across the street from a Home Depot was shut down, but the Home Depot was open. You'd have some home builders that were allowed to continue to build their homes. Other home builders who applied for a waiver were denied. Nobody really understood why, and that's what the Auditor General really looked into. They looked at about 150 cases of these waivers that were either granted or denied and said it was not transparent. There was no real sense in terms of honesty and integrity in terms of how these decisions were made. And so he said this audit is to prevent something like this from happening in the future. And hopefully they will be able to do that.
All right. Well, soon after taking office, Jason, Governor Hochul signed the HERO Act. We haven't mentioned that much on this show, but this is huge. Are you concerned at all that this might become a burdensome mandate on small businesses as COVID is still raging in New York?
Yeah, we are. You know, under the HERO Act, the New York HERO Act, every employer in New York has to have a workplace safety plan in place that really protects their employees from COVID, so personal protection equipment and other basic things. But there are concerns because the legislation would allow an employee to sue an employer for up to $20,000 for violations of this policy. That could become a very large mandate on small business across the state during a troubling economic time.
Yeah. Michael, last week we talked a lot about the Republican efforts to investigate the 2020 election, and the fallout has begun. Democrats are suing to stop this election investigation. Why are they opposed to this forensic review?
Well, I think the listeners can probably figure that one out by common sense. But in reality, what's going on here is the Pennsylvania Senate, led by the Senate President, Jay Corman, and Senator Chris Dush are leading this investigation into the election. And the Senate Democrats have sued in Commonwealth Court. I think this will eventually end up in the Pennsylvania Supreme Court. And basically, Democrats are saying it's not the job of the legislature to investigate elections. The challenge is, though, that the executive branch has dropped the ball. The executive branch, I think many would suggest the Wolf administration, even in complicity with the Pennsylvania Supreme Court, toyed with the election before November of 2020 and made some changes that created questions about election integrity. And I think it's reasonable, and most Pennsylvanians think it's reasonable, that somebody look further into what happened in November of 2020.
Yeah. Criminal justice reform, Jason, was back in the news this week with the recently approved Less is More Act, initially having to do with Rikers Island, but this is a statewide bill, and many in law enforcement say it's going to make our communities less safe. Do you share those concerns?
I do. Essentially, there are criminals that have not yet completed their sentences, but they are out on parole. And if they are out on parole and then there's a technical violation, they don't make it back to their home at a certain time, or they're in an area they shouldn't be, they may not go back to prison under the Less is More. They're going to not have to go back at all. And there are concerns. If you can't keep the rules on parole, how are you ever going to keep the law?
Yeah. Well, hey, after the pandemic delayed it, it is finally here. Michael, I know you are busy preparing the first ever Pennsylvania March for Life is just a few days away. Hard to believe it's just around the corner. A lot of our listeners are interested and excited to go. What do you hope this event on Monday will accomplish?
We're really excited about it. There's about 75 buses that are coming to Harrisburg from all over the state, including many in your listening area, and still some openings on some of those buses. What we hope to accomplish, number one, is to make a bold statement for the legislature, the governor, and those who have the ability to do something in law to protect human life in the womb, is to make a bold stand and to encourage them to do the right thing related to the sanctity of life and to encourage more action in protecting human life. The second thing is to inform the audience about a court case before the Pennsylvania Supreme Court that could put us in the same league as New York and Virginia. This court case before the Pennsylvania Supreme Court would seek to mandate taxpayer funding of abortion and find a right to abortion in the Pennsylvania Constitution. That's a real threat on the horizon. We have a fix for it that's going to take every pro-lifer to get involved, and that's what we're going to be talking about.
All right. Again, that is Monday, September 27th. Had to look at the calendar for a minute, but just around the corner. And like you said, the buses are not all the way filled. There is room if you would like to attend. And Michael, so much information about that on your website. Where can folks find you?
PAfamily.org.
And hey, learn more about the New York Hero Act and why you may be concerned if you own a small business. Jason, where can folks find out more information about that legislation?
OpenTheUpdate.com.